So timer also, what we have a counter where the register that is associated with counter will first set it up. So one more point with PWM is, and that is correct for timers also, that PWM uses timer for its application. That counting that sort loop which is there, it is generated from timer. So timer will start as soon as we give it a clock pulse. As soon as the clock pulse is present, it will start counting. So let's say 8 bit timer, it can count from 0 to 255. So every pulse, it will count from 0 to 255. So now let's say my frequency is 1 megahertz. It is 1000000. Okay? So in 1 second I have so many pulses. So if I start counting the number of pulses, as soon as I reach this many pulses, I can say that 1 second has passed. Right? So for 0 to 255, as soon as I reach 255, how much time has passed? I can calculate it from here. I know this is the frequency. So I'll say for 1 megapulses, time equals to 1 second. For 1, it is 1 by 1 megapulses. And I have 255. Once the counter value is 255, that means I got 255 pulses. So 255 equals to 255 by 1 megapulses. This many seconds. So as soon as my value reaches 255, that means this much time has passed. Right? Now I want to calculate 1 second. So I can use this time to calculate how many steps of this much time I need for 1 second. Let's say this I for 255 count up to 255 I get 100 milliseconds. So I need 100 milliseconds to count 1 second. 100 milliseconds, if I get 10 times, I got 1000 milliseconds. That means 1 second has passed. So I'll use this time. How many such steps do I need for 1 second? So I will divide 1 second by this value, I will get that many pulses. So I can use one more counter, that as soon as, whenever the value goes to 255, next pulse it will overflow to 0. So at that time I will increase the counter. I take one variable counter. And I will configure the ISR, the interrupt service routine. That as soon as this the microcontroller, it will give you a flag. As soon as this overflows from 255 to 0, it will set a flag, and if the interrupt is enabled, it will jump to the ISR. So I have the ISR here. I will increment the count. Count equals to count plus 1. Okay, so now I know whenever 255 comes, I am jumping there. So let's say to count 1 second, I need 41 steps. 41 times the count should reach 255. So here if I count to 41, I will say if count greater than equal to 41, that means 1 second has passed. Right, and then I can set some flag and do something done. So when that set is every 255, I'll enter here, I'll increment count. As soon as count becomes 41, I'll say 1 second has passed. That is how I'm measuring time using timers. So how many such steps you need, that you can also calculate by dividing this by 255. You got it? Understood now? Now, there can be 8-bit registers, there can be 16-bit registers. Timers, they give you the option that do you want to count till full value or do you want to count till a particular value. So if you are counting till a particular value, it will come from 0 to that value and again come back to 0. Then go up to that value, then come back to 0. Or you can take that value, come down to 0, then go back, come down to 0. That also you can do. That depends on your application. And through the resistors again, you can configure. Now you see, this frequency may be very large for you. So you want to decrease the frequency. So what you can do, the microcontroller gives you an option that either you can give external pulse. In one of the pins, you give pulse from outside. Or you can prescale the internal pulse. Prescaling means dividing the frequency. So if I divide this by 8, I am giving a prescaling factor of 8. So this will be how much? 125. This is the new frequency for the timer. Now this frequency is less than this one. So to count 0 to 255, I will need more time. So this number of steps will reduce. This count here also will reduce. Right? So that is depending again on your application, what is the amount of time you want to measure, what prescaling you want. Okay? So now if you divide this one by 255, you will get the number of steps that you need. So this might be something, some value. I have dot ABC suppose. Now this is the error that I have. Right. So I am saying that exactly when this much steps I get, I will say that 1 second has passed. But my counter can take, this register can count only integral steps. So let's say I get 625.52. So I can count 625. But I cannot count 0.52. So this one is the error. So always select a prescaler that will reduce this much as much as possible. Okay. So prescaling is clear. Then again, as soon as you give the frequency, timer will start. When you want to stop, stop the frequency. And you have the interrupts also. With the interrupts, you can configure the ISR. You enable the interrupt. As soon as this timer overflows, you will get an interrupt and you service the interrupt.